All right, this is like made in America, Bitbox. Everybody's got one in their shop like this. And it has letter bits, number bits, fractional bits. Everything from, I think the smallest is 40 thousandths, all the way up to half inch. That's where this comes to. This is the biggest one, half inch. Old style 14 in, new style 14 in, everything in this box, it'll take it. We just rebuilt this one, put some really nice grease on it, and that's like butter. And you pick a bit out, put it in there. Now obviously this will be in your machine, but boy, there's a nice positive clamping there. Get your chuck key. And when you mess with a lot of machinery, you can just feel that just fit in there super nice. And there's the sleeve. So this is one of the more versatile, I think, super chucks, because it'll do this entire box. It's big, but it's not necessarily too big for some machines, but it's got that great universal characteristic. Those chuck jaws are gonna come all the way down to zero right there. So what do you need again to rebuild it? You need your chuck, you need your service ring, minimally a paper clip. If you're just gonna lube it, you don't need to buy anything else, you just need some grease. You might need a file or a little stone or a wire brush for cleaning, the normal complement of abrasives. This is super handy because it's got a magnet on both ends. And it helps you put the balls back in the raceway. These are pretty commonly found in your shop. And, you know, maybe a deluxe rebuild, you'd put this stuff in your ultrasonic tank. And if you get one that's got a really bad burr, you might need to do some reaming on the hole. But boy, I've really found that between the file and the stone and then just feeling in there and doing a good cleaning job, maybe some emery cloth, this has rarely been necessary for rebuilds that I've done. But 14 in, super versatile, easily rebuilt, feels like butter, it's ready to go for another 20-30 years. Replace the grease from time to time, it'll take care of you. So this one's labeled Spud Hightower right here. He was proud of this chuck, he liked it. And wherever his machine shop was he worked, he really liked this thing. It was probably his, so he labeled it. And this one feels good. You can tell this one's not been marred on this backside by somebody taking it apart without a service ring. This is a newer one. It just doesn't look as clean, doesn't look as nice. It's got some dings on it. Maybe it's not been stored as well, even though it's a newer one. So there's the rebuild on a 14 in, one of the favorites of the shop. So this is the more modern Jacobs chuck. It's got a service kit number, differentiates it from others, but its just design is a little different. It's still got the crack nut, but this is a caged ball raceway, and all the ball bearings are held in that cage. So they're a little easier to replace and do, but they still need cleaning and lubrication. And this one has kind of a different set of markings on it to denote which jaw is which in here. Pretty interesting. But you can pull yours apart with a service ring, decide what you need for it, put it back together, use it for a while till your service kit comes if you need it, or leave it out of service. Just pop that back on and press this back together. Put it back in your arbor press and you're good.